Hi, welcome to the Fall Artist Showcase. My name is Anna Casillas, and I'm the Visual Arts Coordinator at the Art Depot Gallery. I'd like to extend a special thank you to the Mayor, the City Council, and the City Manager for their wonderful and continued support of the arts. Our featured artist showcase works are terrific and captivating. His work oftentimes includes unexpected objects, and he also likes to add sometimes a 3D element to his artwork to further captivate people's interest. Please help me welcome our showcase artist, Pablo Lazo. Welcome, Pablo. We're so happy you could be here today.
I'm glad to be here too. Thanks.
Now, your artwork has generated a lot of interest from people visiting the gallery. We've gotten a lot of comments about how they like your painting skills, but also some questions on how they're really interested to learn more about your subject matter. So we're happy you're here today to learn more about yourself and your art. So share with us the story of how you got your start as an artist.
Hi, I'm Pablo Lazo, and I was born in Cuba, and I immigrated to the United States in 2004. And I became an artist about 12 years ago when I graduated from the Academy of Fine Art in Cuba. But I have been doing art-related things since I'm 8 years old or something like that. And that's basically.
Wow, since you were eight, that's a long time. Well, that's great. Now, kind of touching on what I said earlier, your paintings are so unique and they're so captivating. And you really do make use of this 3D aspect. Like in this one, it's a 2D painting, and then you have this string and nail that kind of come out. And it really kind of gets people's attention. How did you come up with the idea behind this kind of art?
Well, this group of work I did, I developed it. That was the first group of work that I did when I first came from Cuba. Mm-hmm. And it's basically, all of them is autobiographical. And those are objects that I made myself and people that I know, and basically the whole country make these kind of objects and in the everyday life, you know, like they use it and they're part of their like routine every day. And I was interested in like how one object is used doesn't end in the, you know, the first use, you know, like how they recycle and it's recycled again. And that caught my interest, and I did this series all about that.
No, that's very cool. And yeah, we just noticed that this was a wheelchair rim. And so that totally does fit in your theme of recycling something over and over and having many uses. This one's kind of connected, but you use unexpected objects. So you use a lot of times these cans, this Arizona iced tea, the marionettes. Can you tell us a little bit about the story behind that or the significance?
Well, yeah, this was a group of work, basically talking about my background and how I became it was hard to me at the beginning when I start to choose a subject matter for my work. Mm-hmm. And it was always there. And I just look around and did what I have around me. And that's.
Okay, yeah, because I know these cans with the lights you used to use because you wouldn't have electricity. Yeah. And then you turned to using these, and these were commonplace items, and these turned into your lamps. So,
In Cuba, we suffered a lot of power outages. Mm-hmm. And in that particular case of that pieces, those pieces of the oil mm-hmm. lamps are like, we make it to light ourselves at nighttime.
That's really interesting. I've never seen anything like that before. And when we explain that to people visiting in the gallery, they all of a sudden are like, oh, and they look at it with a different kind of light. So explain to us a little bit about your influences. I'm sure you have a bunch, but what's a couple of your artistic influences and why?
I have a lot, but the main ones are this Cuban painter. His name was Leopoldo Romanach, which for the early 1900s, and he was the founder of the Academy of Fine Art in Cuba. And for me, he has a lot of, influence on, even though I never met him, but he did a lot of good work, and I really took a lot from him. And it's not just painter or artist or writers, it's just one guy that has influenced me a lot lately is this guy from Australia that he makes, he's one of the last coopers, like those guys that make the wine barrels. And,
oh, okay.
And yeah, it's a variety of people that help me. I get a little bit from everybody.
Oh, that's very cool. You pull all the best things that you see from other people. Now, when people look at your work, what do you hope that they take away from it?
I don't know. I hope that they help me to solve this crazy puzzle that is life, I guess, and understand a little bit my concerns and preoccupation. And
okay, yeah, that's great. Talk to us a little bit more. The theme of your artwork is called Locus. Could you expand a little bit on that theme and what's the connection to these paintings?
Yeah, Locus is a Latin word that more or less meaning like creativity and how people deal with, and then it has to go hand to hand with this group of work because I was like basically the backbone of the show was how people deal with creativity even though they have like no resources. You know, like when you have a lack of resources, basically the only way out is if you use your mind, your creativity to get out of it, you know, to solve problems. And that's basically the main idea of the show.
Okay. Oh, that's cool. That helps. I wondered what the title meant, and that does help. And then lastly, how has your work evolved throughout the years?
It's a good question. And for example, this is the first batch of work that I did since I was out of Cuba, and now I'm working like things completely different. You know, like this is more autobiographical, like more visceral, and the things that I'm doing now have to, it goes a little bit more wide, you know, like the concept is not localized like this kind of work. And I'm working on that. The problems and the concerns are completely different now. And yeah, like I have evolved a lot.
Okay, so you've expanded your focus more and more general?
Yeah, like a more general, not just general, more, how can I say this, contemporary problematics, like, you know, like it's happening like worldwide.
Okay. Thank you so much for that great interview. I think we've learned a lot more about the story behind some of your subject matter and artwork, and that's really great. So thank you very much. If you'd like to see more of Pablo Lazo's artwork, please visit the Art Depot Gallery or the foyer outside the Grover W. Taylor Council Chambers. His work will be up until November 22nd. Please visit our website at arts.fontana.org or call the Art Depot Gallery at 909-349-6975. Thank you very much. See you next time.